fake news, misinformation, and straight out lies about the global warming is so abundant nowadays, it is not uncommon to find people who firmly believe that the whole thing is a hoax. One of the most common misconceptions about global warming is that it is part of nature's cycle and humans have little to no effect. Some people think that the sun and cosmic rays are the main reason. This graph here debunks this theory. Indeed, there were multiple climate changes over the course of Earth's history, but you can see a very sharp upward spike since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. This is a clear indication that we are affecting the Earth's climate. Natural climate change is influenced by things like changes in the Earth's orbit, variation in the sun's output, and volcanic activity. The science says Earth's temperatures should have gone down in the last 50 years if only accounting for natural causes. It may seem logical to think that CO2 would not have a big impact on the Earth's atmosphere, since it forms a very small portion of it. Indeed, CO2 only takes up 0.04% out of the total volume of air. However, even in small amounts, it can influence the whole globe because of its powerful heat-trapping properties. If you think about it in relation to strong chemicals, even just 200 milligrams of cyanide can be fatal. For the last million years, CO2 levels have mostly stayed below 280 ppm, but since the 1800s, it has soared to 415 ppm. This increase in CO2 levels directly coincides with the rapid rise of global temperatures. Another point that should be understood is how the temperature data and simulation models are handled. The measurement data is collected from various science organizations all around the world. The records are then tuned by data experts to compensate for issues such as instrument variations and urban heat island effect. There are a lot of different temperature records which were conducted by various independent groups with their own unique methods, and their results are surprisingly similar to each other. Early computer-powered climate models in the 70s and 80s have proven to be accurate over time. The models that exist today are more advanced and constantly compared with each other. When a majority of these models agree on a general trend of the global climate, you can be almost certain that this will be scientifically accurate. As for claims that the data is rigged, it would take thousands of scientists in more than 100 countries manipulating data for more than a century to pull off a conspiracy on the scale. 97% of active climate scientists are in agreement that the current global warming is 95% likely to have been caused by humans. Considering the wide range of agendas and interests of the various countries and individuals, the consensus itself is a powerful evidence. Scientists are just in it for the money. This is another myth invented to discredit the global warming message. Aside from the lack of evidence to these accusations, the fact is that these scientists could easily have made 10 times the money working for a fossil fuel company. A lack of commercial interest in the area means that most of the funds they are granted goes to cover basic expenses. What really motivates them is to better understand their will, push boundaries of human knowledge, and thus contribute to the wider society. With 80% of the world's most wealthy companies dependent on fossil fuels, it is not hard to see why global warming issues is met with such a widespread skepticism and misinformation.